How was everybody's weekend? I hope it was good. I'm just going to let everybody come in right quick and then we'll get started. It was good and busy? Okay, same. Same, same. It was fabulous. Oh yeah, mine was great too. I mean, I had stuff going on, but like I had my gig on Saturday and that was a lot of fun. Everybody was like so accommodating, so nice. I did not wind up having to do Ice Ice Baby. We are still going to do it at some point, but they started requesting other songs. So we ran out of time and this white girl didn't get to rap. Can you imagine? Oh my God. I was prepared, but it was better that we didn't because I wanted to be able to like practice a song as a band, and we had a sub drummer, which means he's not our regular drummer. He had to come in and fill in for our regular drummer. So it would have just been better just to like wait anyway. So yeah, universe was looking out for me. Okay. So that was my weekend. Nothing too major. It was fun. Lots of storms still. You guys, I'm so freaking tired of these storms. Like, what the fuck is going on? And we got more coming in today. And I'm just like, I don't mind the rain, but it's the severe thunderstorms and the flash flooding that I have a problem with. So, I mean, it is what it is. Best birthday weekend ever? Oh, good for you. Happy birthday. Hey, Miss Heather. Okay. I did not get to do the 80s costume, but let me tell you, I was really bummed, you guys. But let me tell you, it's probably the best that we didn't because it was an outdoor gig and it was so hot. I had bought like leggings and the leotard and everything. So it's probably better that we didn't, but I did do like a little homage to Dirty Dancing. I had on like jean shorts and this one tank top that she kind of wears in the movie for like a hot second. So I did a little bit of that, but all in all, it was like the gig was like a triple birthday or something like that. Like, I never know what the whole gig is about. I just show up and sing, do my thing, and then go home. So this was like a triple birthday or something. They had a food truck. They had bartenders. They had, I mean, everything. And it was like a massive pool party. And the people were so nice and so accommodating. And I loved getting to do gigs like that. Private gigs are so fun, typically, because the people are excited that you're there. They want to have fun. They loved us. I posted a couple of snippets of videos in the collective, if you guys are in there. Again, it is not like you're not hearing the full band. You're hearing what we hear on the stage. So it doesn't sound the best, but at least you get to see some of what I do in the gigs. I will try to get like a legit video sometime soon. But as far as right now, that's the best that I could do. So you hit a storm on your way home from Oklahoma. Yeah, so did my son. He was coming back from McKinney and it was insane. And his little car, I call it a roller skate. It's so little. I think it's like a, what's it called? Chevy Trax or something like that. So I'm like, you know, be careful when you roller skate. Yeah, the outfit on the bridge. It was like a pinkish color. Yeah, tank top. And she had on Keds, but I put on heels because, you know, you have to dress it up. But yeah. But then when I got there, I had to walk down this like steep decline. And these like rocky steps. And I was like, okay, these heels are not going to last. So I just stripped them off and I brought flat shoes and wore those. So anyways, enough about me, but I mean, that's how it goes in gigs. You never know what's going to happen. So anywho, all right, let's get started. You guys, if you're new here, welcome. We meet up here every Monday and Friday at 9:30 a.m. Central Standard Time, because we want to discover what is coming up for us for the week ahead. On Mondays, I pull cards for Monday through Thursday, and then on Fridays, I pull cards for Friday through Sunday, okay? First, we're going to get our heart chakra back in alignment because, as we know, everything goes into our chakras, it affects our chakras, and we need to make sure we're operating at full capacity, okay? All you have to do is listen to the singing bowl. If you can, sit up as straight as you can, put your feet on the floor, relax your shoulders, relax your jaw, relax everything, and just listen to the vibration. Your body will adapt to the vibration, okay? So here we go. Keep breathing. Now everybody take one collective deep breath in. Pick it up, everything heavy. Pick up everything heavy with your breath. Now blow it out quickly. You always want to take these deep breaths, expand your lungs, pick up all the heaviness and anxiety, and then blow it out, okay? Because you're getting rid of that energy. You can do that as many times throughout the day as you need, especially if you're like me and you're a shallow breather. I'm a very shallow breather, especially when I'm sleeping. Exes have told me that they'd have to like check on me throughout the night to make sure I'm still alive because I breathe so shallow and I don't move a whole lot. So yeah, if you're a shallow breather, make sure that you are breathing nice and deep every now and then picking up any fear and anxiety with the breath and then pushing it out, okay? So let's begin by getting our fairy blessing for the week, and then y'all are going to pick the deck that I use, okay? All right, let's see. What is our fairy blessing for the week? Y'all, my right eye has been twitching for over a week now. It's crazy. How many times are we going to get this card? Okay. The blessing of Queen Mab is all about taking your power back. And I feel like we need this card often as a reminder. Okay. Because we are always enticed to give our power away. You know, I was thinking about this yesterday when I was watching somebody on TikTok Live, a reader, you know, some rando, some guy, and looked like somebody, his page wasn't even about tarot. It looked like somebody that just like picked up a deck and decided he was going to do readings. So I was watching, and he might have the best intentions, but he really didn't know what he was doing. And so I was thinking about this. I was like, the people that jump on the lives and they ask questions, they want readings, they want this and this and that, they are constantly giving their energy away to any random person that they see on social media. So, and it's not even with just lives, right? It's not even just tarot readings. It's any time you stop and you participate with somebody in social media or in person, you're giving them your energy, okay? So you need to be very selective about who you're giving your energy to. Is this going to be something, that drains you of energy? Is it something where somebody can invade your energy and affect you? There's so many different things that you need to think about before you let somebody in your energy or you give your energy away to somebody, okay? This is why it frustrates me. Oh, thank you for the subscription. This is why it frustrates me when people come onto my live and they immediately start popping off questions to me. They don't even take time to listen to find out what we're doing here. They just pop on and start asking questions, expecting me to perform or give them a reading, right? They just gave their energy to me and I refuse to give it back, right? Because that's not what we're doing here. I'm very selective of who I give my energy to. So this is telling you to, number one, call your energy back. We do this every Sunday in the collective, right? I give y'all a reminder every Sunday to call your energy back. And then you want to be selective throughout the week of who you give your energy to, okay? So we'll see how it pertains to the tarot. This eye is so weird how it's twitching. I researched it and it does resemble like good luck. So, I mean, hey, I'll take it. Okay, so y'all need to pick the deck that I'm going to use. Deck 1, Tarot of Mystical Moments, or Deck 2, Tarot Mucha. Tarot Mucha. I like saying that one. Deck 1 or Deck 2, put it in the comments. Just vote one time, please. And everybody on Instagram and TikTok, please help me keep track. Deck 1 or Deck 2? So far, twos are getting it on TikTok. Oh, on Instagram as well. Okay. Might be a bit of a landslide. I'm just watching. So Deck 1 or Deck 2? It wouldn't surprise me, Heather. So it looks like Deck 2 is definitely winning. So let's go with the Tarot Mucha, okay? Y'all made it easy on me. Okay, make sure I didn't have the other cards in there. No. All right, let me shuffle them. Twos have it. Thank you so much. I thought so. Now remember, if you're wanting to learn how to read tarot, I've created the self-paced tarot apprenticeship for you. You can find that through the link in my bio, okay? This is where I take you by the hand and walk you through the complete process on how to read tarot, all right?